Excuse me, I thought we were supposed to be leaving from Sydney Airport. It's in the other direction.
Oh, there's been a change of plans, Miss Hunter. The Shackleton Cooperative has arranged a private helicopter for you.
Another change of plans. Great.
Luke, honey, I know things haven't been easy for you since the divorce, but this new job will give us a chance to start over.
We're moving to some backwards town a billion miles from nowhere. How is that better? We're even further away from Dad.
You'll still get to see him, holidays and some weekends. This was a great job, Luke. This will be an exciting move. I've heard great things about your new school.
Yeah, you said.
You won't be the only new student either. The whole town is still finding its feet, so there'll be plenty of others who haven't been around long.
Great.
This way, please.
Phoenix Files, Man in the Shadows, by Chris Morphew. Adapted by Benjamin Maio Mackay. Starring Julia Shiaka, Benjamin Maio Mackay, Sebastian Cooper, and Paul McGann.
Hi there, I'm Aaron Kedley. Welcome to Phoenix.
Hi, I'm Emily. This is my son Luke.
Great to meet you both. I'm the residential liaison officer here, so I'll be showing you your new place.
That'll be lovely. Thank you.
Hey, who's that guy over there? The one watching us?
Oh, that's Officer Bruce Calvin, the Chief of Security. If you could both come this way, please.
Everything's so new, so polished. Do you have a team of 24/7 cleaners or something?
Mr. Shackleton insists on only the best.
There's a ton of security here. There's no other planes.
Oh, we're just closing up for the night. You're the last ones in.
Hey, Aaron, is it typical to send an army helicopter to collect workers?
Luke!
That's all right, Miss Hunter. Yes, we typically use the army helicopters. They're simply more efficient. And Luke, I wouldn't be asking that many questions if I were you.
What?
Through here, please.
Hey, can I borrow your phone? I don't have any reception. I just want to call my dad. Let him know we got here, okay?
Sorry, buddy. All our phone lines are down at the moment. Oh, same with the internet. The tech guys are working on it now. We'll be back online soon, I promise. Well, it's getting dark. Let's get you guys to your new place. Grab a helmet.
What are these for?
The ride into town. Come on, your bikes are around the back.
Excuse me?
Miss Hunter, car use is highly restricted in Phoenix. We're only a small town, and we find that bikes are the most convenient way of getting around.
I haven't ridden a bike in years.
Don't worry, it'll all come back to you. It's just like riding a bike. Either way, it's only a short ride.
Define short.
45 minutes or so.
What kind of town doesn't even let you
That'll
drive?
Be fine.
Beautiful, eh?
How far out does the bush go?
It surrounds the whole town. It extends for miles. Very picturesque, don't you think?
It's perfect.
Weirdly perfect. Do you have a contingency plan if it catches fire?
No need to worry about that. Our security centre is equipped with the best firefighting gear on the planet. All our safety and security systems are absolutely cutting edge.
You really don't like cars, Mr. Kedley. There's not a road in sight.
As I said, Emily, very few cars operate here, so why build roads? All these bike tracks are far more convenient for residents. They extend right around the city. There isn't a place here you can't get to on a bike track.
All these houses look the same. It all looks so fake.
I can assure you, Luke, that this is all real. We only brought in one architect for the project. He was simply the best. Ah, here we are, 43 Acacia Way. This is your new home. Here's the keys.
Thank you. Our luggage?
Oh, someone will be by in about an hour or so to drop off your luggage.
Lovely, thanks.
Anything else I can help you with before I keep moving?
No, thank you.
Well, I'll leave you to it. Enjoy Phoenix. It's wonderful to have you as part of the family.
Luke, I know this isn't an ideal situation, moving so suddenly and...
And being so far away from Dad?
And being far away from your father. But this isn't the end of the world. I think it'll be good for the both of us. It's a clean break.
Sure, Mum.
Morning, Luke.
Uh-huh.
I'm on my way out. There's some food in the kitchen and a town map on the bench. It's all very straightforward. I left you some money too in case you want something else for lunch. I'm going to do a proper shop tonight. If I get caught up at work, it'll be takeaway though.
Okay, Mum.
You're okay to get to school by yourself?
Yeah. Hey, I don't have a uniform. Or, like, anything.
It's all there already. The uniform was in the closet and there's a bag full of books down here. Oh, and you're supposed to get there early so you can meet the principal.
Woo. Hey, everything's in my size. How did they know?
Must be a good guess.
It's a bit weird though. You know, my clothing size, there's no cars, my phone still doesn't work. And they wouldn't let us keep any of our old furniture.
Yes, but look at this stuff, sweetie. It's so much better than our old things.
I know. And I mean, this place is huge.
Bit of a change from the apartment, huh?
Yeah.
See? It's not all bad.
I suppose. But here's the thing I don't get, though. Why is there so much security? They're everywhere. There's like 12 people in this town.
They're just trying to keep us safe, I suppose.
Mum, it's weird. Where would you ever see this many policemen?
Luke, you stress too much. This is a new city. Of course they want to protect it until it gets up on its feet.
Okay, all right.
Well, I've got to be off, and so do you. Have a good day, sweetheart. I'll see you tonight.
Is this Phoenix High?
That's right. So you must be Luke Hunter. Luke, welcome. I'm Mrs. Stapleton, the deputy principal here at Phoenix High.
Nice to meet you.
Our principal, Miss Pryor, apologises for not meeting you personally, but she's been held back at a meeting. Here, this is yours.
What is it?
Your new laptop. Every student receives one when they arrive. I'm sure you're aware our external internet connection is down presently, but your computer will still be able to send and receive emails within the town. We have our own intranet. Peter, may I see you for a moment?
Oh, it wasn't me, miss. It was Tank. He tried to hit me with a bin.
Peter, which class do you have in first period today?
English with Mr. Larson.
Excellent. Peter, meet Luke. He arrived yesterday. Will you show him around?
Sure, no worries, miss.
I'm trusting you to be sensible here, Peter.
Miss, am I ever anything but...
Luke, right?
Yeah.
Let's go find your locker.
Do you need my locker number?
Nah, everything's in order of arrival, so you'll be after Jordan.
What?
When a new kid arrives, they just give you the next locker in line, and everyone here is pretty new. I've only been in town for 6 months, and I was one of the first to get here. So Staples gets me to show you around, even though she hates me. I'm practically the only one here who knows where everything is.
Yeah, right. Hey, Peter, do you think...
Yeah.
The Shackleton building in town, do you find it unusual?
Well, it's definitely the biggest here, but nah, not really. Why?
I don't know. It just seems imposing. It's like he's saying, I'm in charge, especially with a big sign. We know who you are. There's like three businesses here.
It's the most creatively named building here.
What do you mean?
Well, this is Phoenix High, across from Phoenix Mall, which is near Phoenix Airport. And Phoenix, you get the idea.
No, please continue.
Hey, look.
What?
You got the last locker.
What? Does that mean something?
Dunno. Guess it means you're the last arrival.
What do you mean I'm the last one coming? You literally just said there are people arriving all the time.
Yeah, but this town is invite only. I mean, Shackleton built it for all the people who work at his company, right? And who else would want to live out here?
Right. You reckon the school knew exactly how many people were going to be here and ordered that exact number of lockers?
Yeah, so? Oh, quickly this way, we gotta go.
Hey, Weir, who's that?
Oh, this is Luke. He arrived yesterday. Luke, that's Catherine. The other two are Tank and Michael.
These your friends?
Used to be, yeah. Hey, Jordan,
Something I can do for you, Peter?
Just wanted to say you are no longer Phoenix High's newest inmate.
Wonderful.
She's kind of in love with me. It's a bit embarrassing, really.
Sure. Sure.
No, seriously. She may try and hurt her feelings, but I know deep down.
Ah! Oh, yeah, that's true love there, man.
See? Textbook love-hate relationship. I should report you to Staples, Jordan. Violence against a fellow student is not something we take lightly around here.
Keep whining, Mr. Weir, and I'll give you something to cry about.
She's kidding, right?
Yeah, I think.
Morning, everyone. Yes, Peter?
Hey, sir, we've got another newbie.
Oh, yeah, they told me about you. Luke Hunter, right?
Yeah, nice to meet you, sir.
You've got impeccable timing, Luke. You see, today, we're starting a brand new book study. I'd like you all to read The Shape of Things to Come in the next few weeks.
What? Come on, sir, be reasonable.
However, I realise that this is about as likely as Peter ever getting that haircut he so desperately needs.
Hey, now.
So, we begin the class today by watching the movie adaptation. However, I must warn you that at some point you'll need to read the book. I'll know if you haven't.
See, getting around school isn't that hard.
Thanks, Peter.
And the schedules really aren't that complicated. Are you heading out?
Yeah, I am.
Well, come on then.
So what's up with all these guards?
They work for Mr. Shackleton. We have them instead of cops.
And that's legal?
Must be.
But doesn't the government ensure there's police everywhere?
I don't know. Well, it's not like we need them. There's like zero crime here. This is my stop. Dad's finishing work early and I'm supposed to meet him here. He works at the Shackleton building. What does your mum do?
She's a human resources manager.
Meaning?
She gets paid to tell companies how they can use their employees better.
Puff gig.
So this is the Shackleton building up close?
Yeah, it's like our town hall, I guess. Meeting rooms and offices and stuff.
Pretty big town hall. Is that all that goes on in there? Just meetings?
Yep, that and the alien autopsies, of course. Mate, you're becoming paranoid. Just because a building's big and black and shiny doesn't mean there's something going
on. All right. Sorry.
Look, it's all good. Just try and relax, will you? Phoenix is a little weird, but it's an okay town once you get used to it.
Okay. See you tomorrow.
Yeah, see ya.
Maybe he's right. Maybe Phoenix isn't that bad after all. Mum? Hey, Mum? Hey, Mum, did you clean my room? Who the hell's been in my... What's this?
What's wrong? Are you okay?
Someone was in my house.
What?
Look, they made the bed and they left behind this USB.
Somebody made your bed and you're worried?
Well, we don't have a cleaning service, do we?
No.
And I know nobody else has been home. Mum just doesn't have time.
All right, let me see the USB. Something's etched in the side. JB.
What's on the drive?
Just one file. lhunter.doc.
Well, it's definitely meant for me.
It is all gibberish. Just garbled letters. Look, maybe it's just some prank, dude.
Are you sure there's nothing else there?
Look, let me have a look tonight. Just, you better go. My dad will be here any minute. I'll send you an email if I find anything. Just don't stress. This town is safe.
Luke, I've got dinner. Sorry I'm so late. It was wall-to-wall meetings all day. I didn't even see my office until 4:30. I'll shop tomorrow, at least enough to cook a proper dinner.
Right.
How's school?
Yeah, all right. The phones are still down.
Same in town. I spoke to my boss about it. Apparently they've been offline for almost a month now.
Huh? Seriously, what's taking them this long?
She didn't say. This is a small town, though, pretty isolated. Remember, this whole place was built from the ground up less than a year ago. There's always going to be hiccups along the way.
A month with no phones is not a hiccup.
What do you want me to call it? It's not ideal, but they'll sort it out soon enough, I'm sure. We still have the internet, though, so it isn't that much of a problem.
Sure, unless your dad's hundreds of miles away and not reachable.
What?
Nothing. I'm going to bed. Night, Mum.
Okay, good night.
Now, what did you find, Peter?
Sorry, mate. No idea what this is. I think the file has been corrupted. The only JB I can think of is Jordan from school. Maybe ask her tomorrow. See you then, Peter.
That's not much help. Man, this place is infuriating.
Morning.
Hey, who's that guy I saw on the way in this morning, sitting in the square? I didn't think there were homeless people in Phoenix.
Oh, yeah, that's Crazy Bill. He's our resident hobo.
That's what people call him, Crazy Bill.
Yeah, I guess mentally unstable, but probably still pretty nice. Bill just didn't stick.
I thought the town was invite only. Where'd he come from?
Dunno, must have snuck in somehow. They usually try and keep him off the main street, but he's not really hurting anyone, is he?
Well, why doesn't anyone help him?
Not sure. Guess someone should, hey.
What are you working on?
History project. Stalin was World War II, right?
I think so.
Awesome. Now that's done, back to the memory stick.
Any more ideas?
Well, I did check the town registry, and there's only two JBs in town.
Jordan Burke and...
Julian Burrows. He's a maintenance guy who takes care of the fountains. Let's assume he's not the one we're after.
Okay. Jordan, then. But why would she send this to me?
Who knows? Maybe she wants a date.
What? I only arrived 2 days ago.
All right, relax, dude. I'm only joking. You wouldn't stand a chance with her anyway.
Oh, that's right, because clearly she's all over you.
All in good time. Come on, there's an assembly this morning.
This auditorium's huge. None of my old schools had anything like this. Who paid for it?
Shackleton. Apparently the cooperative people are like mega multi-billionaires. Probably built it with their loose change. Where's Jordan?
Hey, what do you reckon the file is?
Oh, there she is. Other side of the hall. We can catch her on the way out. Ask her what's going on.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, quiet down.
Crap, I just lost $5.
Huh?
Oh, we're taking bets on Pryor when she'll show up at assembly. I had $5 on it being today.
Well, she wasn't here when I arrived yesterday.
Yeah, we've barely seen her since the start of the year. She's always holed up in that office of hers.
Doing what?
Oh, doing principal stuff, I don't know.
How long do these things usually go for?
Around 45 minutes.
Crap.
Get used to it, dude. There's loads of these things.
Thank you. Let's make a start.
Finally. That's over. I thought Staples was never going to shut up.
Quick, let's try and catch Jordan.
She's over there. I think she's heading towards us.
Blast, she's gone.
Yeah, I've lost her.
Oh, we can find her later on.
No need. She's got design and tech next. Come on. If we're quick, we can catch her before she gets there.
You know her timetable?
Can't blame a guy for doing his research. Look, there she is.
Boys, slow down. Are you lost, Peter?
No, Mr. Hanger, we're
just... I'm sure you can find a more direct route to our history class. Getting there on time might be a nice change for you, don't you think?
Oh, yes, sir.
Well, he seems pleasant.
Oh, he's one of those old bitter teachers. He's always getting angry at his students.
Well, where can we find Jordan next?
Don't think we're going to have to look very far.
What do you want?
Huh?
You think I haven't seen you following me around all morning? You think I don't know what else you've been up to?
Hey, Jordan, I don't...
You wanted my attention? Well, here I am. So let's hear
it. Whoa, Jordan, why are you getting so fired up?
Tell him.
What?
Well, Luke, why don't you tell Peter what's got me so fired up?
Jordan, I don't know
Tell him what you were doing after school yesterday.
He wasn't doing anything. He was in town with me for like 15 minutes and then he went home.
Yeah? Then who broke into my house and left this? Look familiar, huh? It's got your initials on it.
Actually, yeah, kinda does. This one's got your initials on it.
What?
Well, how about that? I think we all have some talking to do.
Sorry. I'm really sorry, guys. It's just this place. Ever since we've moved here, I can't shake the feeling that there's something not right going on.
Don't worry about it. What's on that USB, Peter?
It is another Word file.
It's just gibberish, though.
Like mine.
I don't think so. Look what happens when we put the two... Look what happens when we put the two next to each other.
What is it, then?
I don't know. It's definitely something.
Oh, good. Thanks for clearing that up. Luke, have you told your parents about this?
No. Dad's back in Sydney, and with no phones, I can't tell him anything. And my mum's not exactly...
How come your dad's not here?
My parents aren't together anymore.
Oh.
That a problem?
No, it's just unusual, that's all. The other families around here are all... I just think you might be the only one whose parents aren't together.
Nice going, Peter. Way to make him feel included.
Oh, I didn't mean...
Forget it. What about you, Jordan? Did you tell your parents?
No, I was going to, but they've got enough to worry about. I figured I'd...
Take me on yourself?
Well, yeah. I guess that's the point of all this, though, right?
Well, someone's gone to a lot of trouble to bring us together.
What, you two?
Yeah, the initials. They wanted us to find each other.
And look at the file names. They're the same on each. They just change our names. See? What if they're two halves of the same message or code or something? Like, what if we put them together and we get a full picture? What are you doing?
Hang on.
What I don't get, though, is why us? Even if that's true, why did this person choose us for whatever this is? What do we have in common?
Oh, you mean other than an irrational paranoia that this whole town is out to get you?
You still don't think there's anything weird about any of this?
Sure, it's weird. But you don't even know what it says yet. It may be worth waiting until we get it figured out before you start going insane with conspiracy theories.
Peter, what are you...
It's not a text file.
What?
It's one file split in half, but it's not a document. It's something else. A picture or a sound clip or... I don't know, something.
Can you open it?
I think so. It'll take a while to put it back together. I'll take the files home and work on it tonight.
Don't you have an essay to rewrite?
Stuff hanger. Besides, how could I possibly concentrate with all this excitement going on?
Hey, sweetie. Sorry, I still haven't been to the shop yet, but I have takeaway pasta.
It's fine, Mum. I've got some homework to do. I'll be right down.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Any news on the phones or the internet or...
Nothing yet. I'm sure it'll be fixed soon.
Yeah, sure. He got it.
Hey, Luke. I figured out the message. It's an audio file. I've listened to it a couple of times already. It's got to be a joke, but I reckon you guys should probably hear it for yourselves. Meet me at the fountain tomorrow morning, 6:30 a.m, before it gets too crowded. Mate, if this thing is legit, we are all in some serious trouble.